And every time that there's a misspelling, I'll spell it out for you. So this is from a mayor of the city of Colorado named Tim Boyd. And this is something he publicly posted for everyone to read directly directed at the citizens. Here we go. And remember, I am reading this directly as I can. Let me hurt some feelings while I have a minute. No one owes you, ARE, your family anything, nor is it the local government's responsibility to support you during trying times like this. Sink or swim, it's your choice. The city and county, along with power providers or any other service, owes you nothing. I'm sick and tired of people looking for a profanity handout. If you don't have electricity, you profanity, up and come up with a game plan to keep your family warm and safe. If you have no water, you deal without and think outside of the box to survive and supply water to your family. If you are sitting at home in the cold because you have no power and are sitting there waiting for someone to come rescue you because your YOUR lazy is direct result of your raising. Only the strong will survive and the weak will perish. PARISH. Folks, God has given us the tools to support ourselves in times like this. This is sadly a product of a socialist government where they feed people to believe that the few will work and others will become dependent upon them. Yada 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 yada. There's more to that post, but I'm done. I mean, if you are going to be in politics, oh my God, at least know how to freaking spell. Beyond that, you got a goddamn smartphone or a computer, and you still can't get those words spelled right. You got the wrong words, wrong use of your, the wrong r. You meant our, not r. Beyond that, perish. See, I'm gonna search that now. Because I'm pretty sure it's. Yeah, perish. The proper spelling of it is PERISH. I was hoping that would work. Ah, there we go. See? Perish. A little bit closer so you can see. Ain't clear, but you can kind of see it. Verb. Used without object. To die or be destroyed through violence, privation, etc. To perish in an earthquake, to pass away or disappear. An age of elegance that has forever perished, etc., etc. Perish, on the other hand, like he used, PARISH. In the Christian church, a small administrative district typically having its own church and priest or pastor. Oh. In Louisiana, a parish spelled with PA is a territorial division corresponding to a county or others in other states. U.S. has bizarre words, but the rest of us don't. But either way, that's the incorrect use. Because he was talking about dying. Now, beyond all of that shit, I'm pretty certain that the Christian God would want you to help your neighbors and support them and do good. Am I wrong? Really, am I? Beyond that, moving on to something less asinine and more concerning than a politician who can't spell and thinks he can get away with saying whatever the fuck he wants on social media. PEI, the place where I live, has its first case of that UK variant, the incredibly infectious one. And you know what? That's concerning. Very much so, because our schools are still open. And those tiny, cramped hallways that everybody is going through at like this, you're lucky if you at one point you don't brush up against somebody else. Stay in focus, camera. So that's happening. On top of that, you've still got people who don't wear masks. And I know there's people out there who are mask exempt, but I really don't believe that's a thing. If you can't wear a mask, you should not be out in public. Just that simple. Seriously, it's simple. Wearing a mask bothers you? Why are you in public? Go home. You are not going to be at risk, and you're not going to put others at risk, because you know what? Asymptomatic is a goddamn thing. Wear a mask. Keep your distance. If you are one of those people who's honest to God think that you don't need to wear a mask because of, I don't know, maybe you've got some PTSD or trauma relating to having stuff over your face. I can get that. Or maybe you have some sort of severe breathing problem. Again, I can get that, but in either situation, should you really be out? You can't wear a mask, therefore you can't protect yourself or other people, and God forbid that you are asymptomatic, walking around with the virus shedding throughout your body and spreading it around to other people. Just because you don't feel ill, just because you think that you don't need to wear a mask. Smarten up, please, honey. There's people in this world who are vulnerable, who are at risk, who will die. And the province that I'm in, we have not had any deaths yet from COVID, and I pray and hope every day that there will not be any, because that once that starts, you know, that's bad. This is an island. We're small, we're tight. Tight-knit, I mean. And yeah. So don't forget that COVID is still a thing. If you're a politician, use spell check. Love and light, Lena.